increasing efficiency, reliability, and productivity while reducing costs and human error in industries is achieved only after the introduction of industrial automation systems. Over the years, electromechanical relays are the most common devices used for industrial automation systems. However, relays have limitations in terms of speed, flexibility in programming, diagnostic capabilities, and space occupancy. Hence, they are replaced with PLCs in modern electrical panels due to their advanced capabilities in automation and control. Today, we are going to learn about what is PLC. What are its components? And how do they work? Welcome to Mr. Smart Engineering. Subscribe and support us to provide more contents like this. So, what exactly is a PLC? At its core, a PLC, or a programmable logic controller, is a specialized computer designed to control manufacturing processes and machinery. It's like the brain of an industrial operation, executing tasks based on inputs it receives from sensors and other devices. They have wide advantages over the traditional relay-based control systems and some advantages like their flexibility in programming, reliability, performance, speed, and minimum space consumptions makes PLCs a better option for industrial automation. Rather than that, wiring and diagnosis of issues is more simple when compared to the traditional automation systems. A PLC is the combinations of several components working together to provide better automation systems. The main components of a PLC are: power supply module, central processing unit CPU, communication module, input module, and output module. A power supply module is the primary module of any PLC. They provide the necessary power for the operation of PLC and its components. The power supply modules used in PLCs are generally classified into two types: an integrated power supply module, which is built into the PLC base unit and directly powers CPU and I/O modules; an external power supply module, which is typically a separate external unit that supplies power to CPU and I/O modules. A PLC can have either one of them to power their components, or both in case of a larger applications. A central processing unit, or CPU, is the brain of PLC, and it is responsible for processing the logic and executing the control tasks defined by the PLC program. This is the core element that monitors all modules and controls the entire automation process. A communication module enables the PLC to exchange or transfer the data with other devices and modules. These modules play a vital role in the most important process called programming. Programming a PLC involves creating logic using specialized software. This can range from simple ladder logic diagrams to more complex scripts, depending on the application. The communication module establishes connection with programming devices and allows data transfer to the PLC memory and retrieves the data from PLC to the programming device when requested. An input module of a PLC is responsible for interfacing with external input devices such as sensors and switches. These modules bring the input signals into the PLC for processing. The input modules are generally of two types: a digital module, which receives only digital or binary signal from input devices, and an analog module, which receives continuous analog signals from input devices. An output module of a PLC is responsible for controlling external devices such as actuators and motors. Similar to the input modules, the output modules are also classified into two types: a digital module, which generates only on or off signal for an output device, and an analog module, which generates continuous analog signals for output devices to operate. Both the input and output modules are associated with memory devices of CPU. And memory is the place where all the data are stored and processed. The primary unit of a memory is called a bit. A bit is a digital form of memory which an electronic device can understand. A bit can be either 0, resembling the off state, or it can be 1, resembling on state. All the ports in an input or an output module is associated to a memory bit. In case of an input module, when the input device connected to the specific input port turns on, the memory bit associated with that port turns 1. The CPU, which is processing based on program written, checks this memory bit on each scan of the program execution cycle. According to the changes in the memory bit associated with input module, the CPU takes necessary logical decision and modifies the memory bit associated with output module. The output module now generate on or off control signals to the output devices. According to the values in its memory bit associated with respective ports in the module. This how the input and output is processed in PLCs. Hope you have enjoyed this journey through the world of PLCs. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insights into technology and automation. See you next time.